I'm Dan Macon. I am a co-owner of the Flying Mule Sheep Company in Auburn, California. I am also a county-based livestock and natural resources advisor with the University of California Cooperative Extension here in the foothills. And I was the original executive director of the California Rangeland Trust. So when I started my professional career in livestock 30 years ago now, livestock grazing was really viewed negatively. And in 30 years, we've come full circle. I think we've really started to acknowledge that grazing can be an incredibly important tool for managing large landscapes, that well-managed grazing does things like improve wildlife habitat, control invasive weeds, help maintain watershed function. Because we're grazing these landscapes, we're sequestering carbon in ways that we wouldn't be able to do otherwise. And in targeted grazing, we're able to reduce fire danger. And I think the fire threat has really driven, most recently, this kind of rejuvenation of interest in grazing as an important tool. Within targeted grazing, we really try to get the right animal at the right time for the right amount of time to treat a particular type of vegetation. So maybe an example would be yellow star thistle, which is an invasive plant that we have here in California. We want to hit that right about the time that it's flowering. So we target a specific time of year with animals that will actually eat it. And again, not every animal is going to eat every plant. So we want to make sure we're matching the animal and the animal's nutritional needs with the plant at that particular point in time. There's a place for just about every kind of grazing animal in a targeted grazing scenario. We've worked with people that have used cattle to target graze fine fuels for fuel load reduction, or even brush in the Sierra Nevada, where we're grazing a particular type of brush at a certain time of year. One of the issues that I think is really important to keep in mind in targeted grazing, though, is how that nutritional intake matches with the rest of the animal's needs. So one of the advantages that we have with sheep or with goats is that they have a much shorter gestation period. They're only pregnant for 5 months. So that gives us a longer time frame that we can use those animals to manage vegetation. We're coming off probably the worst wildfire season in California history. We burned over 4 million acres last year. We've seen wildfire season start earlier and go later. So I think it's that challenge is just accelerating because we've got so many people moving to areas like this. And really, I think the bottom line is that grazing and prescribed fire are the only tools that actually remove vegetation. We obviously can't burn in a neighborhood like this. And so grazing is really our only option to take what could be flammable fuel and convert it into fiber and meat and other products. Ruminant animals have the ability to take the cellulose that's in this grass and convert it to other things, and that's really what we're using targeted grazing in the context of wildfire. We can also use the other impacts of grazing animals to manage fuel. Not only are they consuming it and grazing it, but we can use trampling on the landscape to change the fuel profile. If we put that vegetation in contact with the soil, we're going to speed nutrient cycling and carbon cycling in the system. But we're also reducing the amount of oxygen surrounding that fuel. And oxygen is one of the key elements in fire, that if we can change that fuel profile, we reduce the intensity of wildfire. We've done targeted grazing for a variety of clients. We've worked with individual landowners. We've worked with PG&E, actually. We also work a lot with homeowners associations. What we provide is a way for those associations to treat larger landscapes, to treat areas where it may be too rough or too rugged to get somebody in with a mower or a string trimmer. We work with homeowners associations that for whatever reason decide that they don't want to use herbicides on a broad scale. And certainly with homeowners, the thought of intentionally setting a fire to control their fire danger is a non-starter for a lot of them. And so we'll work with homeowners here in the foothills. We bring all of our own fencing, we bring our own water troughs, we bring a corral system if we need one. So we're totally portable, and we can pretty much put sheep anywhere on the landscape with our border collies and with our electric fencing, and really target the impacts that the homeowners want to have on the vegetation issues that they're concerned about. You know, I think we are seeing now the effects of less grazing throughout California. We simply have lost the ability to manage millions of acres of vegetation. Grazing is an important tool for treating these large landscapes that we couldn't get to otherwise. And I think if we can rebuild our capacity to graze rangelands in California, not only does that have economic impact, but it's really going to reduce the threat of wildfire in these landscapes.
Thank you so much to Dan Macon and the Flying Mule Sheep Company. We hope that you enjoyed this presentation and learned a lot about targeted grazing.